leta hun. I swear an oath. It's all symbolic. But amid the symbolism, so much can change. Today, Modi's core team, Sushma, Jaitley, Rajnath, Gadkari, stand intact. Nirmala joins their number in rank, if not in experience. But today is not a victory, it's a fresh beginning. CEO Modi has hired and fired. And now we await our return of investment on the faith this country has put in, concentrating so much power in the hands of the BJP. Here's what's happened. Then we examine how that can and must be put to good use.
मैं पीयूष वेद प्रकाश गोयल
मैं मुख्तार अब्बास नकवी
मैं धर्मेंद्र प्रधान
देव बीन प्रमोटेड
मैं डॉक्टर सत्यपाल सिंह
मैं राजकुमार सिंह
हाय हरदीप सिंह पुरी
द टेक्नोक्रेट्स आर इन
आई Alphonse Kanandhanam.
May Anant Kumar Hegde.
And one each from Kerala and Karnataka. But the big bang was her, defense minister no less. Now it's up to them to deliver. They're full of thanksgiving and promises.
The new team now has to deliver the last mile for Prime Minister Modi to win the next Lok Sabha elections in 2019. Apart from GST and demonetization, Modi government has several flagship schemes and has already done more than 7,000 mini reforms. Modi is politically stronger than ever, but this new team has less than 20 months to deliver. And the Congress, failing with its ideological war, is hoping it can hammer this home.
So the message of the reshuffle is maximum government and no government.
It all boils down to simple questions. So much has been put in place or begun by Modi government in the last 3 years. How much of it can be measured or felt tangible for the government to not only win India, but ensure that India wins the world? The clock is ticking. With camera person Ratnesh, Brijesh Pandey for NewsX.
Okay, let's have the debate. Joining me on the broadcast, Javed Ansari, senior journalist. I also have Praful Ketkar, editor-in-chief of The Organizer. Narendra Taneja representing the BJP tonight. Mohammed Khan with me in the studio representing the Congress. And Asif Bamla, senior NCP leader, joining us on the broadcast as well. Javed Ansari. Now, I mean, the big bang was Nirmala Sitharaman. That was one taking the cake. But if you look at the larger scheme of things, this has been a more a CEO hiring, hiring and firing than anything else. What do you make of it?
Certainly. I mean, the elevation of Nirmala Sitharaman is an inspired move. It's a progressive move. The elevation, he's rewarded merit by elevating the likes of Dharmendra Pradhan and Piyush Goyal, but he's also tolerated mediocrity by continuing with Uma Bharti and Suresh Prabhu. But beyond the symbolism, now is the time, like you said, the last mile, the clock is ticking. Now is the time to deliver. The mismatch between perception and delivery and performance has to be addressed, and I'm not so sure, given the short span, just 20 months before the next elections, whether that can. The biggest challenge before this government, I've always maintained, is the economy, is joblessness. I don't see anything from the reshuffle that has happened today. Nothing that has happened today inspires me about what this government is trying to do and whether they will be successful in addressing this
problem. Okay, let's find out. Praful Ketkar, now here it is. I mean, come on, Modi is politically stronger today than he was in 2014. Got all the states, the presidential, vice presidential elections, everything has been put in the bag literally. But when it comes to delivery and moving away from symbolism and promises, so much has been put in the works. You know, we've been discussing from the petty things like a simplification of the income tax form, 7,000 reforms, a shipping license, marine licenses, which had to be renewed every year, have been made a lifetime. Lot of petty, small things. Is this, Praful Ketkar, about all those small things like puzzle pieces falling together? Or should we now be expecting big bang, more bigger, more headline grabbing?
I don't think that we should look for the big bang. We should look at the things that are actually reaching to the grassroots. See, please try and understand, putting the things on track in last 3 years or creating infrastructure to putting the things on track was the basic goal. And as far as, you know, the as the numbers goes, you know, as far as the 30 crores accounts are concerned, or direct transfer or benefit schemes are concerned, 78% electrification work is concerned, these are definitely numbers which has directly delivered, or for that matter, even Ujwala. You know, these are the things which directly touch the common masses. But as, you know, Javed Saab has actually said, the real point is about, you know, the perception and delivery. At perception level, this government has been managing well. And that's why, the you know, they are getting the results on the ground.
Yeah, well, the most
important point is, please try and understand that this government first time has evolved a self-regulating or rather self-evaluating mechanism mm-hmm. to assess the performance. You know, and that's why it was easier for anybody to guess those new names.
I believe it's categorized as performance levels for ministers have been categorized in those performance.
Pragati,
evaluation.
4P
evaluation.
That was very important. When did we see that, you know, going beyond the caste and regional and all those considerations?
Okay, again, I began by that. Let's not suggest that those were not there at all, but. Were there the overriding concerns? Maybe not. Okay, Narendra Taneja, now come in on this, sir. The cabinet expansion is done. It's your party's prime minister's prerogative to pick the team that he wants to pick. He's picked this team. He's surprised a few people. Nirmala Sitharaman, great idea. That's going to be inspiring, and it was a great coup. But it comes down to the brass tacks, sir. For people who are watching this broadcast, about the tangibles. Now, my question to you is, in your opinion, you're a man who understands these things well. In your opinion, is this about stitching together the puzzle pieces better? Or are you hoping on big reforms? Because we are still pending, for example, an Air India divestment. Some big things are still pending, sir.
Well, last 3 years, what we have done, many big reforms, empowerment of people. Just look at the number of people who, you know, have got bank account now, number of people who have access to electricity, number of fishermen who have easy access to loans and to fishing. And the list just goes on and on and on. The last 3 years actually have been of great performance, great delivery. And that's why, you know, people are voting us to power state after state after state. And what the Prime Minister has done today, when you are presiding over such a team, as a Prime Minister's team in a parliamentary system, let's not forget that.
Yeah.
And the past few years, a great performance, and now he has brought in some more people. At the same time, some people are going to do the party work. And as you can see, as cabinet has also been slightly expanded. What for? Basically, to focus only on one thing, that's delivery, so that every single commitment made to the people of this country is, to the best of the government ability and capability, is delivered.
Okay, but it's difficult. Let's be honest. I mean, it's easier said than done, sir.
And all credit to the effort that has probably been made.
And some of the reforms, the tiny ones that don't make the headlines, I'm going to highlight those on your screens. We're calling them the mini reforms. You're going to keep on highlighting them. I've picked about 14, 15, which don't make the headlines often. But they do matter. But Narendra Taneja, my question to you is, when that tangibleness has to come across in a narrative that, yes, our lives have become better, they are today and will be better in 2019 than they were in 2014, what is then your driving purpose? Are you looking at the state governments to better implement, at least the BJP-ruled states, to better implement the schemes? Are you looking for greater investment to come in from the center? Perhaps worry about the fiscal less? Worry about what's happening on the ground rather than the macroeconomic GDP pictures? What's the thematic purpose here, sir?
Three things. Number one is basically to make sure the benefits of the development, particularly the work we have done over the past 3 years, are available to the last person, the last man in the queue. There's the poor, the middle class, the lower middle class, backward communities and all that. Number one. Number two is to basically strengthen the very foundation of the Indian economy, root out corruption, get rid of black money, get rid of parallel economy and so forth, so that at the very bottom of the pyramid, India's economy is solidly strong. Therefore prepare India for the next leap, that is, you know, new India and beyond, of course. Number three, at the same time, is work in complete coordination in sync with the party, so that the party and the government are working, you know, in tandem and making sure that we are prepared for the next big challenge in terms of delivery. the promises that we have made, and also, of course, for the next election.
All right.
But just one thing, when we talk of the big ticket reforms and all that, the big ticket reform is when we empower the poor men of this country.
Okay, I mean, at least you tried to offer a path out. A lot of people don't offer that, Narendra Trivedi. I appreciate that. Now, repeat the courtesy, Mohammed Khan. The Congress is all failure. You know, it's a very fact that the government is being hiring and firing people shows it's all a con job. This is all spin. Nothing has happened on the ground. This is a bit different from what we were being told 2-3 weeks ago when we were being told it's an ideological war. But given Mohammed Khan, what has happened? What is a better idea that the Congress has?
Well, you're absolutely right. Everything you just said is not a statement of opinion, but a statement of fact. Recently began the debate by saying that Prime Minister Modi is at his strongest ever.
He is.
And I think you, and even to some extent Javed Saab, are being kind to him. You guys are being charitable to him, and I'll tell you why. Look at the constellation of circumstances in which this is taking place. Modi ji is facing some of the most significant challenges his government has faced, whether it be Gorakhpur, whether it be the train derailments, whether it be unemployment. Doesn't matter.
He's broken the politics,
as you have rightfully known.
You can debate him on economy, maybe.
Let me just make my point. But as you have often said in this debate in the past, there is a distinction between politics and governance. And here we're only talking about administration. That's what the reshuffle is about. I think right now the perception, sir, from the organizer said that the perception Modi's created is of work. When there's a 46% increase in farmer suicides, I think the perception is exactly the contrary. The last point I want to make is this, and it's a twofold point. The first point is, I think this reshuffle reflects a deficit of talent. The fact that they brought in these four people, one of whom isn't even a member of parliament yet, though incredibly credentialed, don't get me wrong, This demonstrates to you that
two of them are not members of parliament.
So that implies that ek kami hai. Now, finally, I want to say this. Look at the three people who've been elevated. And this is why I say this is the equivalent of moving the deck chairs around on the Titanic. Again, Rishabh, very astutely, you guys correctly pointed out, 16 mahine reh gaye model code of conduct lagne mein. What will they achieve in this last month?
Well, 16 months. A lot has been done. Yeah, very quickly finish your point.
30 seconds. Nirmala Sitharaman presided over the single biggest fall in exports over the last few years. Dharmendra Pradhan presided over the single biggest increase in diesel and petrol prices. And Mukhtar Abbas Naqvi, come on, that's tokenism. You and I both know.
You know, I would love to be countered on all of that, but hang on a second. I want to get Asif Bamra. We've been discussing to death over the past 2 or 3 weeks as rumors have been flying of whether your party is headed the NDA's way or not. But given that you're not in it, sir, right now, here comes the bottom line. If you are to criticize, you can't criticize the cabinet expansion because that's Modi's prerogative. But if you are to criticize the performance of the government, then somebody has to come up with an alternative, better performance that, you know, had it been us, we would have done Make in India this way. We would have done Skills India this way. Nobody criticizes that. Why not?
Well, the reshuffle has happened, the third ever reshuffle in maybe 38 months. We welcome the move, obviously. It's the Prime Minister's prerogative, who should be his colleagues, who should not be his colleagues, who he should be inducting in the cabinet. As my friends from the BJP and the Congress have spoken, I would like to highlight two specific points here. One is the inclusion of Anand Kumar Hegde from Karnataka, who was caught beating up the doctors. I mean, that is how you treat professionals, and this is how you are rewarded.
We discussed that this morning.
He's been. I'm afraid that he should not be granted the portfolio for health. You know, unfortunately, he has been having a wrong and a bad track record in Karnataka. Obviously, maybe his induction is with the eye and with point of view with the forthcoming elections in Karnataka.
Okay. And the second,
he's known for his communal speeches to incite. And the second issue, obviously, Nirmala Sitharaman ji, we welcome the full-time women defense minister. We've had Indira Gandhi ji in the past. We've had strong stalwarts like Sharad Pawar ji, who's led the defense ministry in the past. But having said that, you reward people who have delivered more than expected. And when it comes to Nirmala ji, with due respect to her, she is now the defense minister. But if you see, as a commerce minister, she has, the performance has been crippling. It's nothing extraordinary.
Okay, you can't have it both ways, Asim Bhadla. We welcome a woman defense minister, but we criticize the person. Okay, you made your point, sir. You made your point. Unfortunately, you did not answer my question. Prabhupada Kedkar here becomes a...
Let me complete my point. Let me complete my point.
Answer my question. What's the better idea that you have?
We are not criticizing. We are... You're talking about the defense minister?
No, I'm waiting for your ideas for this country, sir. So you seem to claim that you know better. Then give us the idea. Show us. Asim Bhadla, show us. Tell us. This is what we would do.
No, the idea is there are very many senior leaders also. In fact, senior leaders have been put to rest, if you ask me. I mean, again, as
I'm sorry, Asim Bhadla, that's not really an answer, sir. That's not presenting as an idea. They're saying there are some senior leaders we should get in. I'm going to get in proper case. I've let you make your point in peace, and you got the point across. Both of our Ankamar Hegde and Nirmala Sitharaman. Prabhupada Kedkar, now come in here. When we ask
as a commerce minister,
further, probe a little deeper. It's okay to criticize the government. That's an opposition job. Both the Congresses as well as the NCPs. But when you ask for ideas, why do you think they're not coming up? Mr. Kedkar.
See, simply because if there would have been ideas, especially the Congress would not have seen the 2014 downfall. Congress has created this perception about whether it's picking up people. Even yesterday also I was reading somewhere, does that mean that these people are corrupt who are moved out of the cabinet? You know, is that the only criteria to move people? Either, somebody should be corrupt or somebody is close to the family, then he is in. Or he or she is in, that kind of nonsense we have to go
to. Where have you lost the narrative? I keep trying to have this question of a narrative of what needs to be done for the country.
Understand
and
the mandate,
never having it. Why?
Mandate this government has got is on the basis of changing political culture, the larger perception about the political class. And as far as on that front is concerned, there is no major, allegation as far as the corruption is concerned. There is no major, any of the...
So are we losing Javed Ansari? Because we've been told for the past few weeks and months since the presidential election times that it's about Atma, it's about ideological war, and this is what it's all being fought for. Now it's about delivery, and you said that delivery on the ground has to be the core concern, and that's literally where the BJP, which has so much power concentrated in it, can either deliver or fail. Why is it that nobody's coming up with better ideas, sir?
Well, I'm not so sure this is the forum for better ideas. The better ideas will be in the manifesto. The better ideas as far as the Congress of the UPA is concerned were when they were in power. Some of it were a success, some of it weren't. So this, I'm not so sure if we are the right personnel or this is the right forum. As far as the deliverables are concerned, yes, Mr. Modi has a lot to his credit. There's a lot also where he and his government have been found wanting. Principally, especially on the economic front, there's a huge agrarian crisis staring everybody in the face. We in the media haven't focused in the manner we ought to have been. The opposition hasn't been able to raise it to the level that it should have been. There's increasing joblessness out there.
That's
two. Yes, that again, there is very little evidence from so far on what the government intends to do to tackle these issues.
Okay, let's tackle them because they're serious issues. And you hit the nail on the head. Narendra Taneja, in India we can't quantify jobs because as you know as well as I do, the jobs data is wholly unreliable. 90% of the jobs are not in a structured form of an economy that you can't measure them. How do we tackle that head on? How do you even get quantifiable data to know whether jobs are declining or increasing? We don't know. When it comes to agriculture, sir, there is no disputing that there is a crisis in agriculture. It's not a new crisis. It's not a unique crisis. Not the first time it's ever happened. But somebody's got to do something about it. On these two fronts, what are your plans?
Good question. Very good question. Allow me just a little time. You see, you're talking of agriculture. The way we are looking at rural economy as a whole, and of course, agriculture is a very important integral part of the whole thing. So what we are doing for the rural India, we are taking technology there.
We are taking, you know, banking empowerment there. We are taking solar and renewable energy there. And at the same time, we are taking new ideas there. So that's part of the total plan. As part of that, you see the people living in villages or people involved in agriculture so far, they would not be dependent only on agriculture for their welfare and for their plan, for tomorrow. So this is a massive, massive transformation that's going on.
What is your benchmark? What's your benchmark? Is the benchmark that the farmers,
you know,
said reduce,
sign of that. Number
is
two.
Benchmark
number
reducing
two.
Farmer debt.
Number two.
What is the benchmark for measuring this, sir? How do we measure it?
Assuming that everything that Taneja ji says is correct, even that has failed to make an impact on the ground.
Measuring is that, you know.
Okay, so let's give him a chance. I've asked him the question and I've asked him for his benchmarks. Mr. Taneja, go ahead.
Just a second. Let me complete. Let me complete. You see, as far as your benchmark is, it's very simple. We want to see prosperity, and the people are living in villages. They are not dependent only on agriculture for their living. That's the thing. Once that is taken care of, all the suicide and other things would start disappearing. Number two, as far as the job is concerned, I think don't buy the narrative being, you know, used by Congress party for political purposes, which I understand. The important thing is job is not only, we don't look at job just like a sarkari nokri. Job basically, a rozgar and job are two different things. What we want basically is a totally different narrative and backed by the government through various schemes which we have already launched.
Okay.
And the whole idea is that, you know, those who are interested in government jobs, corporate jobs, they go there, and those who are not interested,
they
basically
the
take initiative.
The intention of government should be to unleash
set up their
the people.
Own initiative,
that we
set
provide,
up their own businesses.
We provide the infrastructure.
Yeah. No, it's not intention.
Yeah,
it's
we,
a, no,
it's a
not
fact.
Intention.
All right.
It's a plan in action.
It's an operation. Okay.
It's not intention. It's happening.
Okay.
It's happening on the ground.
But like I say, it's good to unleash the people, and that's how it should be. But there is a scale that the number of people, I mean, we're looking at tens of millions of people being added to the job market. It is as much of a challenge as it is a dividend. Mohammed, go ahead.
Very quickly, I want to say two things. First of all, there is a department in the Planning Commission, now the Niti Aayog, whose job it is to tabulate employment figures across the country. They're specifically designed and have the resources to do that. So I don't think it's a correct answer to say that we can't arrive at a quantifiable figure. Secondly, sir, if the solutions are so simple and known to you, then why don't you implement them? Why has there been a 46%, and this is a staggering number, increase in farmer suicides? Ye log mar rahe hain, jantar mantar tak aa gaye, aap logon ko andaaza dilane ke liye. The Tamil Nadu farmers who are camping out here, trying to get an audience with the Prime Minister, have not been able to meet him for 4 months. So I think there's clearly an inability on your part to realize your vision into action. However, Rishabh, you know, the surprising thing is they have no shortage of advertisements and declarations that they've succeeded.
Okay.
Which is why
right.
this is only a government
of propaganda. I know the India shining argument is the Congress
India
right shining
argument.
Point of view. I know the argument is it's been well used. Okay, everybody wants to come in. I need to take a 2-minute pause. Okay, we are back and we are having an energetic conversation in this country. We must, because we are all looking for a better world, a better country to live in. Come 2022, 2019, whichever benchmark date you want to set. We've been in the middle of it. Praful Ketkar, here's the punchline. We've been talking about jobs, we've been talking about agriculture, then we've been talking about last mile delivery. Then the simple question comes, how is it going to happen? Is it going to be about new ideas? Is it going to be about ideas better implemented? And I want to pose another one. Is this now going to be the union government that has to deliver the last mile delivery, or do we hope that the state governments led by the BJP, who have to implement all these schemes, take the lead, because in the end, they are the ones who have to do all of this?
See, I'll answer that in two parts. One is, you know, how this is going to happen. I think elevation of Dharmendra Pradhan as, you know, cabinet rank minister with skill development as a ministry is a huge message. Till now, it was just an independent charge. So I think that is going to take, you know, this skill development idea to a new level.
No, but how?
Integrated,
okay, what
listen,
do they need
listen,
to do?
Listen.
Yeah.
Integrated infrastructure for delivery is created in terms of either financial delivery or skill development.
Yeah,
the agencies are identified. Now actually going that, you know, this integrated this with, you know, education, mudra and skills. These three things have to come together, and that will be a big challenge for Dharmendra Pradhan. I'm not saying that this is going to happen automatically.
Yes.
But this is going to be, you know, having a full-time skill development minister assisted by an important MOS is going to, you
no,
know,
okay,
this
but
is
what
going
does
to
he
be
do? Because have you been discussing? You've got 18 months. I mean, 18 months isn't going to change everything, but 18 months
is
at least to
Prime
say
minister
that he has tangibly.
Already talking
here is
about
the touch
2022.
In the water, ripple in the water.
18 months was in August.
See, he's no, already no. talking about 2022.
But
he's
that's
not
Mission
talking.
2022.
Yes. So he has larger goals. So he believes that the infrastructure that is created is going to give Because, you know, see, the basic question is Congress is raising too many questions today, and it's fine as opposition, they should do that. But the key question is, organizationally, in terms of ideas, you know, they are not seriously coming up with some great alternatives that they will be able to challenge. You know, their main leader is absent from the country.
All right, LB, we haven't heard from him today. Okay, I'll get Javed Ansari and then I go back to you. Come to you, Mr. Asif Amla. Coming straight to you, Javed Ansari.
What's the question?
Sir, the state question was same. The state delivery, does it happen at the state, so does the union government still now see the last mile through?
Well, the union government is the one that will drive it, but the state governments will have to implement it. And there are also big question marks, two against two chief ministers handpicked by Prime Minister Narendra Modi. We know what happened in Panchkula, Mr. Khattar. He hasn't really covered himself in glory. And Gorakhpur debts, Mr. Yogi, for all the symbolism, Gorakhpur debts hang heavily against the chief minister. We were talking of ideas. Apart from the symbolism that the appointment of Nirmala Sitharaman as defense minister, what is the great idea that it brings to the fore?
Okay, so again, it comes back to great ideas. I'll give Narendra Taneja just a chance to respond to all of this. Let me just give Narendra Taneja a chance to respond to all of this, and I'll come to all of you. I'll come to all of you. It again comes down to whether we need good ideas. In the past 1 week, we've seen 13 A category bureaucrats sacked for failing to do their jobs in ordnance factories. So it's a lot of small things. Is it small things or great ideas? Narendra Taneja, the ball is back in your court.
Well, first of all, you know, Mr. Ansari is saying symbol. It's not symbolism. You see, she did a great job as Commerce Minister. I mean, if there was a kind of fall in international trade, that is more to do with the global economy as a whole. Number two, Mr. Ansari talked about, you know, Gorakhpur and about Panchkula and all that. Look, I mean, you can't really judge the government's performance of the entire duration just based on that. And even in both the thing, in Panchkula also, I mean, there's a separate debate. But the performance of the government has been very, very good. And the same goes for Uttar Pradesh when it comes to there are legacy issues.
Coming back to Congress,
important thing is, as a Democrat and as a Democratic Party, we love criticism, no problem, constructive criticism, but where are the ideas? Congress is just making statement
I have two other issues which I want to cover in the course of the debate. One, of course, is the issue of centralized leadership and the issue of talent. How much will it take for a team in centralized leadership with new talent coming into work? Mohammed Khan, I'll give you a chance first. Mohammed Khan.
Look, first of all, a robust and driven Prime Minister's office and a cabinet is essential to policy formulation. Javed Saab is absolutely right. There are some things that are in the concurrent list, others in the state list. For the state list, state ki puri puri zimmedari hoti. Concurrent means center is the driving force. Now, Taneja Saab said global forces, but Vietnam and other countries who compete with us, unke to exports bade is same period. So clearly it reflects on us rather than global trends. Now, one more thing. I said this in the morning today to you, Rishabh. The fact is, it is not the job of the opposition to suggest alternatives to their brand of governance.
Okay.
We can check them, but with the vast resources and talent at their command, they literally control every single piece of resource that India has. Then there is no excuse for them not to deliver on their promises. And let us just take their manifesto as a starting point, because the manifesto is what they used to woo the public, to seduce the public into voting.
I have a couple
them.
Of things. I know I have to get Asif Amla into the conversation, and I know Narendra Taneja wants to respond. But I have a couple of things just to address a viewer's question, a kind of narrative
what
also.
What have they achieved out of the manifesto?
Ketkal, are we then back to where we were 20 years ago, where everything is now in the faith of the union government, that the government has to lead the way on everything, jobs have to be provided by government, growth has to be provided, agriculture has to be fixed by government, or should we be thinking about unleashing the economy, which is what the narrative we were supposed to be having? Have we gotten lost too much on government?
See, in fact, if you want to go by the actual facts on the ground, your graphics are showing some numbers. In terms of GDP, in terms of Sensex, in terms of the foreign direct investment, and everywhere the government has positive signals to show. No. But more important than that, see, you have to compare it with 2014 when the government took
you
over.
You don't have to compare it with anything.
Okay.
So
but the main point you were making is it is not only about the. It is not only about
the Congress will not tell you what the GDP number in 2014 was, but it will tell you the average.
The facts are shown.
We know how this works. We know how this works. Let Professor Ketkar finish his point. I asked him a question. The question was, are we saying that it is Modi and his government only that have to deliver for India? And that's it. The government has to take the lead.
No. In fact, Modi government itself is defying this logic because they are saying that we will create opportunities, we will facilitate rather than
Okay. Let him. You can counter him. I'll give you a chance, Mohammed.
I can counter you at every point because your party is not existing today.
Okay.
You please let me come on. It is about the whole idea of cooperative federalism that will have to, carry forward to actually deliver the things on ground.
So let me pick this forward with Asif Bamla. Asif Bamla, here's the premise. Do we always keep now looking that the future of India has to be Narendra Modi and the central government? The central government has to provide the jobs. They have to provide the growth, the agriculture, sucker, all has to be provided. Or do we say that their job is to unleash India?
We have to rise above tokenism and symbolism. We are faced with a massive challenge with demonetization. We are all aware. We've just seen the statements by Raghuram Raman today with the impact of demonetization to the Indian economy. But I would like to say we need to have a robust system because now it's just 2 years down the line.
I understand. Of course, we need to have a robust system.
Today's shuffling.
I understand. But again, my question was: do we need to unleash people, or do we need the government to do all the delivery for us?
Disconnect by the PM. It looked like Amit Shah was calling the shots.
Okay, so we've gone into Amit Shah. I don't want to make a hash of this, Asif Bamla. Let's try to have a cogent narrative. Okay, just hang on. Hang on, sir. I'm going to give Javed Ansari a chance to come in, then Narendra Taneja and Mohammed Khan. Javed Ansari, you want to come in, sir?
The point I was making was this. Look, in an ideal world, it would revolve equally on the state as well as the central government to deliver the goods.
Okay.
But we live in times where one person is credited with all good things that have happened.
Okay, so the responsibility goes up.
If you take responsibility for the success, you need to take responsibility for the failures as well.
Okay.
Or inability to deliver. Absolutely. And meet people's expectations.
Okay, have you raised the bar too high, Narendra Taneja, in the terms? Mr. Narendra Taneja gets the floor. Mr. Taneja, is it the logic that in a system where the system prefers a direct interaction between the PMO and the bureaucracy to get things done, that of course adds extra pressure on delivery on a smaller bunch of people? Have we raised the expectations too much, sir?
No. Look, we got to understand one thing. You see, we believe in that. Our country is a union, and BJP, our party, is a union. We both believe in the federal and decentralized structures. And basically, what the central government is doing whatever the central government need to do, and doing it with full force, 100%. At the same time, helping state government, BJP government or non-BJP government, including Punjab and Karnataka, to unleash the potential that they have. Unleash the potential is a federal structure, and states are also state union territories. They also have to deliver. Mr. Khan said that we cannot offer any substance when we talk.
Okay, so let me take the premise and put it to Mohammed Khan of the Congress. Mohammed Khan.
But he's forgetting in a parliamentary democracy. Look at England. There is a shadow cabinet.
Nobody complains.
And each minister,
when the Prime Minister goes
comes
and
out with complete
helps inaugurate a technological startup summit in Bengaluru. No one complains. It happens to be a Congress-ruled state, but Narendra Modi went there. If this is not cooperative federalism, what is?
That's his job. But I want to say one thing. You're right. Let's turn the debate towards substance. Let me ask the Major Sahab, as I've asked him and his colleagues several times in the past, will you increase the MSP to MSP plus 50 as recommended in the Swaminathan Committee report? That's an abiding and standing request of farmers over the last 3 years. Just do this. This will be a big, big victory for you guys if you do this. Law and order, sir. Haryana has witnessed 3 events since Mr. Khattar took over. Everybody, even people in your own party, speak volumes about his inability to govern. But the Prime Minister doesn't take action or condemn him. I think it would be a good step if you guys started with that. Make an example.
Okay, I'll give you a chance.
And finally, I want to say this. Sir, we have all looked very eagerly to you guys. Because if the nation grows, we all benefit, sir. So therefore, all I've seen over the last 3 years, and please correct me if I'm wrong, you have only a poorly implemented GST and it was a poorly implemented demonetization
scheme.
Okay, all
right. Yes.
You have bought the economy.
Yes, if the nation grows, we all benefit. Yeah. It's not a zero-sum game, but in politics, it often is. Okay, all right. Narendra Taneja, I'll give you a chance to respond. Before I get the others, Narendra Taneja, give us a chance to respond. Three clear points have been raised. I'll give Mr. Taneja a chance. Sir, go ahead.
You see, you see, the question is, Mr. Khan, of course, you know, he picks up things that suits the party. But the question is, he's talking of law and order. What about the law and order situation, you know, over Panchkula in Punjab? Punjab was pushing people into
We are all hearing each other out. And Asif Bamra has jumped in. I'm sorry, gentlemen. Not like this. Narendra Taneja has the floor. He retains the floor.
Don't talk over me.
Punjab was much better handled.
Yes, Mr. Bamra, hold on, gentlemen, hold on. Let Mr. Taneja answer.
Professor sir, you already have a spokesperson.
Let's rein it back.
Mohammad
Khan is not fair. This is not done. Let Mr. Taneja, go ahead.
And when it comes to the point, Mr. Khan, I like to have a civilized debate. I like to have a civilized debate if that's what the viewers want. Let's help the anchor to have a civilized debate.
Finish the point.
Second point, as far as the price, MRP, these things are concerned, you see, we have got a full plan on all these things as I said, the rural economy. Mr. Khan, wait for some time. You wait for some time. We are going to fix the problem in rural economy, which you started and you neglected.
Okay. All right. I have one more premise. I've got 8 minutes with Prabhu Ketkar and Javed Ansari help me define this premise. Do we now, as a country, you know, we are looking for indicators. We don't know other than the voting pattern whether it's working or not working. Right now, the voting pattern says everything's working great. In 2019, will it say 18 months a long time? But, Praful Ketkar, do we look at macroeconomic indicators? Do we look at, GDP is a blip down to 5.7%, whether that's because of demonetization or because of GST, as the government claims? We don't know. Do we look at the macroeconomic indicators, FDI, forex reserves, or do we have to look at some different kind of metric here?
No, see, the point is, what was the main mandate for this government? We have to accept most important point is the political culture of this, you know, you are talking about hire and fire. The political culture was, you know, actually controlled at one family, one place. And, you know, the kind of fiefdom that was created at every level, that was created at every level, you know, that was the real problem.
So as far as now, you're concerned, that's changed. Okay.
That has changed. Secondly, you know, as far as the legal, at the legal level, you know, more than 1,000 archaic laws are being scrapped. Are you not going to consider this as a big reform and big relief?
No, I've been talking about that.
No, because the socialist system.
Prabhu Ketkar again. So you're suggesting the small things matter more.
Yes.
And that's what we need to target in the macroeconomic
indicators. We have to see this picture, you know, in pieces, and it will give a complete picture.
Because I also want to discuss the larger politics.
Now the job of this new team is to, you know, stitch that picture together.
I've been sitting in Delhi. Okay. How do we measure? We measure GDP. We see census. Right, we talk about FDI, you know, we talk about all these big ticket items. In the end, is that how we're going to measure success or failure? Is that the only metric?
Look, give me 10 seconds.
Yeah, I'll come to you, Mr. Taneja. Javed sir, yes.
Look, give me 10 seconds.
Irrespective of what these figures say, there are figures that were, look at the figures that were put out by the government.
Yes.
Just the day before yesterday, yeah. The government said that GDP figures have fallen.
Yeah, 5.7.
5.7. This can be corrected over a period of time. Taneja ji knows economics much better than I do, and so he'll be able to correct me on that. But there is enough and more evidence that there are not enough jobs being created. This is leading to a great amount of restlessness. There is an agrarian crisis. I'm not saying that everything that this, I don't agree with Mr. Khan. My view is different from Mr. Khan that this government has not done anything. But on these two key issues, This government has been found wanting.
Okay, all right. So, Mohammed, okay, now help us understand this on the specific question. Do we again measure this on the big macro indicators, or do we have to find a different metric to measure success or failure?
Look, let's take the OECD guidelines for measuring developed countries. First is infrastructure. Mm-hmm. Second is safe ease of doing business. Third is health. And fourth is education. Now, you tell me, Rishabh, over the last 3 years, have you seen substantive reforms? The NEET crisis reflects that this isn't so. There are, as Mr. Taneja pointed out, due to global factors or otherwise, we argue otherwise, this government has been unable to rein in the economy. We are witnessing the lowest GDP numbers ever. And this is going to be catastrophic for the Indian economy. As far as unemployment is concerned, this is the same government that named and shamed Manrega on its first day in Parliament and 2 years later brought it back with more funds.
Well,
so
okay,
that is an admission of their inability
to control. But the logical argument is that they took the best of it. Okay, that's the argument they make.
Again, you're being charitable. Okay. But the fact is, these people have failed to come up with new ideas.
Okay, it is a all right, all right. You say no new ideas and on a lot of indicators, India isn't doing as well as it should have been doing. I give Narendra Taneja a chance. Mr. Taneja, yes.
In four papers, what did you say?
Yeah, Mr. Taneja, then I want to have one more conversation. Mr. Taneja, finish your point on this.
Yeah, just two quick points. How to measure? I mean, look at India's image today overseas. Look at FDI figures. Look at the way, for instance, even China now look at India. Look at the number of overall number of companies which are coming to India. Look at overall economic stability of the country, peace and stability in the country, and in a democracy. The democracy is not OECD which is going to decide. Is the people of this country, ask the people of this country whether they are satisfied with our performance
okay,
and
survey after
go
survey
for
says
a survey.
They love Modi.
Congress should do his
no,
own.
The government is
performance. More dissatisfied.
We are ready to pay for it.
But not as high as Narendra Modi. And
okay,
that
people
that
of India, they are the one.
That begs my next point. Prabhul Ketkar. Here it is. You've seen the cabinet expansion is a narrative in this. The people that are coming are not mass political leaders. Some of them are, Lok Sabha winners. But none of them are going to swing a state for you and win a state for you. The BJP has made it very clear that Narendra Modi is the man, is going to be the man in 2019. They're not relying on building some other power centers at all. Does the popularity of Narendra Modi, which is still remarkably high for 3 years in power, then become everything for the BJP? Or should the government's popularity be equally high?
I don't think you can differentiate this in any case for that matter, and particularly with this government, because he himself said that, I'm going to present a report card at, when I'm going to face the next election. But more importantly, how collectively party organization and the government work together to take the message forward of the things that are done at the government level.
Okay.
That is going to be the key.
Okay.
It is not going to be decided either by the Congress or OECD.
Okay.
Please try and understand.
Okay.
Yes,
okay.
Obviously.
Did not work, whether the economists agree on it, don't agree on it. There's no denying that Narendra Modi's popularity sold it very well. The people of UP responded to that selling. That popularity is still at a high. The cabinet expansion doesn't show any big political leaders, not even allies, being brought in at a very big level. What does that say about this government relying still on the popularity of Narendra Modi?
I mean, it's a no-brainer. This government is a Prime Minister Modi-driven government. It's a Prime Minister Modi driven Bharatiya Janata Party at the moment, and so long as and BJP supporters would be happy that so long that the Prime Minister continues to enjoy these kind of popularity levels, other things are purely minor details.
Okay, they're minor details. Asif Bamla wants to come in, I'm going to give him a chance. Asif Bamla, you wanted to come in, I'll give you a chance, sir.
The message that the reshuffle reflects is maximum government and no governance. I think the country is faced with maximum challenges, with the GDPs falling down, with the unemployment level, with the borders unsafe. I think this government in place has to take a little more aggressive measures to ensure that things in years. Now we have 2 years to still go. I mean, we don't want to always be critical on a lot of issues. We know that there have been certain ministers that have been also performed, like Piyush Goyalji and stuff. But at the same time, that it's time for for intervention.
You want more aggressive things to happen. You're borrowing the lexicon from the Congress of maximum government, minimum government. I'll leave the last word with you. I just want to address one more question with Praful Ketkar. I will give you, gentlemen, the last 2 words. One more question I quickly want to address because I'm short of time. Praful Ketkar, when it comes to allies, this NDA coalition building, JDU, we understand some negotiations are still going on. Nitish himself perhaps is not so sure who he wants to place in the center. There's an issue there. The Shiv Sena is upset. They've been upset for a very, very long time. AIDMK, there's a tainted issue there. They're not coming in. When it comes to coalition building, is it a factor more so now than it was in 2014? Should it be a factor?
It will be always a factor. It will always be a factor because managing many states, BJP needs these allies, and these are important allies. The problem is, allies like Shiv Sena, they are not ready to accept that, the BJP is not of 1995 BJP, and Shiv Sena is also not of 1995, where they were in much better position to negotiate when they were holding, the controlling entire Maharashtra.
Okay.
So they will have to accept this reality, and somewhere in the cadres, they have accepted the reality. At the leadership level, they will have to accept.
On coalition, Javed Ansari, here's the reality. After UP, the big ticket for the NDA this year, the BJP this year, was Nitish switching over. Let's literally put the opposition in a total mess. Now, when it comes to this coalition, how important does it remain, this kind of adjustments and coalition politics, which haven't been at the forefront and center for a long time?
Look, the terms of engagement have changed, have shifted decisively in favor of the BJP. It's the allies who need the BJP a lot more than the BJP needs the allies. For Mr. Nitish Kumar, he, irrespective of the kind of spin that the BJP and its supporters might want to give, the JDU and its supporters might want to give, he is smarting. We know from leaders very close to him that he's smarting. The Shiv Sena is smarting, but the writing is clear on the wall.
Okay.
It's the BJP which
so
is
the next two tests, and I leave it
it's
on this thought with Mohammad Khan and Narendra. The next two tests coming up, Gujarat, Karnataka. Mohammad Khan, what's your best bet there? What are you going to be campaigning there on?
Well, I will say simply this. Both Mr. Taneja and Mr. Prafulla spoke about consumer sentiment, right? They kept arguing about the fact that people are the ultimate arbitrators of what is the popularity of the Prime Minister. In June 2017 of this year, the RBI, their RBI, though autonomous in spirit, said they published their consumer confidence survey, Rishabh. It is at the lowest point ever since 2013, which means people are not optimistic about their income growth, they're not optimistic about employment, and they're not optimistic about economic well-being.
Okay.
These are the three
parameters. So you're saying this is
going
to have a bearing?
This is what the RBI said.
I'm out of time. My last word with Narendra Taneja. Narendra Taneja, two big battles coming your way. One is the Prime Minister's home state. Karnataka is your foothold or prospective foothold in the south. What's the sales pitch you take there now from all of this?
We will form government in Bangalore. We will, of course, form government in Gujarat again. And wait for some time, we will form government even in Kerala.
Okay, all right. I'm out of time on that thought. This debate can go on forever. I'm glad that at least the core of our discussion has not been a political core. It's also been about India, the economy, and what needs to be done, because that's what should be keeping us awake at night. And we are hoping that that's what's keeping people in government awake at night. The point was made that the success is not of Narendra Modi and his government. The success of India is what is at play over here. Gentlemen, for having this conversation, thank you. Good night.